You're not going to want to miss this episode of the AI Show, where we talk about the evolution of Power Virtual Agents with my good friend Gary. Make sure you tune in. Hello and welcome to this episode of the AI Show. We're going to talk all about the evolution of Power Virtual Agents with my good friend Gary. Gary, why don't you tell us who you are and what you do? You've been on the show many times. We're glad to have you back, buddy.
Yeah, I have. It's great to be back. Hi, everyone. My name is Gary Pretty. I'm a principal product manager on the Power Virtual Agents team. And so we enable anyone to build chatbots and virtual agents in the Power platform.
Fantastic. So last time we had you on, we've had you on a couple of times, but just give us an overview of bot framework. And you said the evolution of Power Virtual Agents. And I know we talk about, how is this all related? Fill us in.
Right. Okay. Yeah. Perfect. So, with Microsoft conversational AI over the last few years, we've had two strands, really. We've had Power Virtual Agents, which exists and lives inside the Power Platform, and was this incredibly intuitive low-code platform that anybody could use to build some, you know, pretty good chatbots. And we've seen incredible sort of usage and take-up over there. Then over in Azure, we've had Azure Bot Framework and the Bot Framework Composer, which I was on talking about the last couple of times. And this is really more focused at pro developers and gave you a lot more flexibility in terms of what the visual designer could do, and a lot more power to build more sophisticated conversations, to model more natural conversations. But the thing we kept hearing from customers is we actually need to marry these two together. And so what we've done now is we've built from the ground up a brand new unified authoring canvas within Power Virtual Agents that can be used by citizen developers and pro developers to build very sophisticated bots without needing to sacrifice the benefits that you get from the SaaS service, where you don't have to manage any of those resources. We do all of that for you. And pro developers and citizen developers can collaborate.
So that's really cool. So basically it's from both ends, you know, from the pro and the low to no code, pro developer, low no code developer, basically you're bringing them together. Am I understanding this right?
Yeah, absolutely. You've nailed it. And it's really important because we have this idea of what's called a fusion team, which is a team that's made up of different roles and different disciplines. And 5 out of 6 organizations that we work with today have these fusion teams. And they want to be able to collaborate together, just like we co-author, you know, Microsoft Word documents or PowerPoint decks. They want to and need to collaborate on these bot building projects. And so that's what we're enabling with this, with these updates.
And that's really cool. I'm on the pro dev side, but I've been leaning towards solving problems with low no code, just because it's like, why do I need to write something if there's something that's already really nice? But I feel like I want to see how this is all done. Can you show us?
Absolutely, yeah. So let's dive in and take a look at the canvas. So right now, I'm in what is in Power Virtual Agents, and this is our brand new technology preview, which you can sign up for today, and I'll talk a little bit about that later on. So the first thing I want to do is to jump into the greeting topic. And for those of you who used Power Virtual Agents before, you're going to notice some immediate updates. We've added some productivity improvements like cut, copy, and paste. They seem like small things to some people who've had them for a long time, but man, they are productivity boosts. For those people who've used Bot Framework Composer before, you're going to see a lot of similarities here now with some of the new actions and capabilities that we've got available. You can now do things like manage your variables, where you can actually manipulate your data, whereas previously variables could only be populated in response to a specific question. And let's take a look at the greeting node specifically. Here I've got my greeting node, and one of the first updates that we've made is the ability for you to add multiple message variations to make sure that your bot doesn't sound stale or rigid over time if somebody's interacting with it repeatedly. So here I've got my same greeting message, but I've got it written 3 different ways. And when the user actually talks with the bot, it's going to pick one of these at random, and then next time it'll pick another one. So that can really help with the experience. And again, what I'm showing you here is really the features that absolutely anybody can use, where we're really improving that low code experience. We'll take a look at the add menu on the send a message node, which I'm using here. And now you can see that previously we could only send plain text messages, and now we've completely broken down that barrier, where you can now easily add images, you can add videos, you can add cards. We'll look at adaptive card later. So I can, you know, say, okay, you know what, I'd like to include an image, you know, an image of my cafe. And as soon as I do that, we get a preview showing me what that's going to look like for the end users. And you can start to see how this low code experience has just been really accelerated for somebody who's building this out.
Yeah. I'm sorry to interrupt, but this is okay. Really cool. It's reminiscent of the bot framework composer that I saw before, but yes. Much revamped.
Right. And I think the point is, right, Bot Framework Composer had some incredible features. But what we've done here is we've taken all of those awesome features and the power and flexibility that you had, and we've infused it into the intuitive low-code platform that is Power Virtual Agents. And so it's just this incredible partnership. Just to highlight one of the other things I can do here is I can add quick replies now, which are suggestions for users as to what they might say back to the bot. So I could say, you know, make a reservation or, you know, store hours. So the user has an idea of what they might say, and they can actually reply to the bot in one click. So I'm going to hit save on that topic. And the next thing I'm going to do is actually I'm going to jump over to another one of our topics. We've actually improved the topic navigation now, so you can switch between them in just a couple of clicks. Previously, it was a lot more convoluted. So let's go take a look at our reservation topic, which I've already started to build out.
So a topic is just basically a flow, a conversation flow thing, basically?
Yes. Yeah, so a topic you can think of as a piece of your conversation, right? And it's a reusable piece. So, and it's usually broken down by use case. So in this case, we've got one topic for making a reservation.
Fantastic.
Yeah. So here for making a reservation, we are asking a question of the user to ask them what date and time would they like for their reservation. And then based on that, we are checking whether or not that is today using our condition node. Using the friendly UI, we can set the sort of the top and bottom of that condition. But what we can now also do is build on top of those conditions with more flexibility thanks to our new PowerFX integration. Now, for those of you who don't know, PowerFX is an Excel-like formula language that's already used across Power Platform in, you know, products like Power Apps, etc. And really enables pro developers, brings really the power that you need to have more flexibility when you're building out your conversations, but also opens the door for those sort of more low-code developers who are coming in and can actually start to grapple this. Because if you've used Excel, you can use PowerFX.
Yeah.
So to do that, what I'm going to do is, what I should have pointed out earlier, is we can make reservations, but the bot is telling you that reservations can only be made for the next 7 days. And at the moment, we're not enforcing that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a condition. And that's going to add a new branch. And by default, we get the friendly, sort of very usable UI, you know, very familiar to anybody who's used one of these sort of tools before. But what I can do now is head over and I can hit change to formula. And once I do that, I can pop this out and I can go straight over to my new embedded PowerFX formula editor. And PowerFX now actually powers the entire variable system in Power within Power Virtual Agents. So not only can I use it to build custom conditions, more bespoke conditions, I can also use it to manipulate my data, set my variables arbitrarily. It really is a big deal. And we've even introduced more complex data types like records and lists as well.
Yeah, this is cool because if someone has like the memory muscle for this kind of thing, it's cool to be able to reuse it across all the Power stuff. So
exactly. Yeah, exactly right. And so you can see here that actually what I've done, instead of having just a simple condition, I've used the date diff function within PowerFX to compare the reservation date time that we accepted from the user earlier with today's date. And I'm checking the difference. I'm making sure it is somewhere between today and 7 days out. And if it's not, then I can click insert. That will add my branch. And I can just send the user a quick message and say, you know, reservations need to be within the next 7 days, right? That's cool. And so that then adds very quickly a nice new branch to my topic.
Yeah, and that's cool because it's like if you're used to doing Excel and stuff like that, you're literally creating like an entire conversation just by hitting the plus with a conditional.
Exactly. And so if I pop open the test canvas right now, which I just did, I can do from the toolbar here, you'll see that the changes that we've just made, I can now test immediately. We can see that it's picked one of our messages at random. It's displayed our image that we added earlier to the message node and the greeting topic. I can hit make a reservation. That's going to trigger the topic that we've just made some more updates in. And now if I say something like, you know, June 30th, 2022, right, for my reservation, what should happen there is it says now reservations need to be within the next 7 days because it's correctly executed that power effects expression that we just added via the formula editor.
That's so slick. And if, I don't know, I do machine learning and those things are hard to demo live. And so this was all like, you just did this. It wasn't like fake. And it felt right. Very slick from a user perspective.
Yeah, it's honestly, some of these things have been much harder to do in the past and would have been impossible for somebody who was, you know, more from a less technical, non-technical background. And so, you know, we're bringing these together. Images, for example, there were ways around it with Power Virtual Agents by trying to sort of use Power Automate in a particular way and return some, you know, some data and you try and hack it together. But we want to make sure that those things that are so crucial to conversation design are just easy, right? Easy and intuitive, and you don't have to look at the docs. It just works.
So you showed us some of the cool responses, being able to embed like stuff, make them really rich. You showed us the power effects. Any other cool things that you have up your sleeve here?
Yeah, so if you remember last time when I was on, we talked a bit more about speech bots. Do you remember
that's
that?
Right. So, oh yeah, we did the demo with the telephone that it called my telephone and everything, which was really cool. Any advances there?
Yes. So last year we announced within Power Virtual Agents the general availability of Dynamics 365 Voice Channel, where you can use a Power Virtual Agents bot to create an intelligent IVR if you're using Dynamics 365 customer service. And that was an incredible step forward for people who want to get started quickly and easily build out these intelligent IVRs. We also introduced a bunch of speech first authoring capabilities inside of Composer and integrated that with Azure Communication Services. Well, once again, just like we've been seeing, we're bringing these two things together. And we are now announcing native telephony support directly within Power Virtual Agents with a new telephony channel, which is in preview. You That's can cool. use this preview to connect an existing telephone number. Honestly, it takes less than 60 seconds to do that. And we've got plans to allow you to connect to your other contact centers. I mean, the reality is many customers out there already have a contact center and they want to be able to integrate, you know, intelligent bots with them. So we're going to enable that to allow you to route your customers to your intelligent IVR, but then onto human agents when needed.
Oh, that's amazing. That's amazing. So you basically just add a phone number and now it's all kind of just magically enabled. Is that right?
Exactly. And I think one of the other awesome things is if we jump back over to our topics list, I've got a, let me see where it's gone. If I jump into my greeting topic, right? So here we can see the greeting topic that we modified earlier. And we're saying, hey, welcome to Contoso, or thanks for dropping by. Well, you'll notice here that I've got this new little drop down in the top right-hand corner of the node. So I can now switch over to the speech tab on this node. And what this allows me to do is provide tailored responses for when I'm using this bot over speech. So I can add a message variation and say something like, you know, thanks for calling Contoso Cafe. How can I help? For example, you could say, make a reservation, right? And so what that's doing is it's providing a speech alternative. And this bot could now work through your website, through web chat, or it could work over the telephone. And I can even insert things like SSML tags. So if I wanted a small break between the how can I help and for example, I can hit my SSML tags dropdown and I can click on break. And that's going to insert the SSML tag for me. You know, just like that, I can immediately start really finely controlling how my bot is talking. And the last thing I'll show you here is if we head over to the general page, and into, we have a new speech tab in the general settings page. I can even pick from one of those awesome neural voice fonts that the cognitive services make available.
That's cool.
You can see here that there's so many available, and we can even test what that voice font looks like. So folks who've never been exposed to these voice fonts, they don't really know what the cognitive services are. We're just surfacing it for them. And so I can do things like I can make my bot sound angry if I want to. So let's see if it will work.
Hi, I am a bot. I can help with account questions, orders, store information, and more.
It is angry.
It is very angry, right? So I'm not suggesting that people should build an angry bot, but if you want to, you can build an angry bot. And that will set the default speaking style and voice for your bot. But then you can use those SSML tags to actually override it at the message level. So it really is a huge leap forward for building intelligent IVRs and making that possible in, you know, connecting to other systems using Power Virtual Agents.
That is amazing. Basically, you have if it's a text thing, you have the drop down to do the text stuff. But if it's a speech thing, you can customize that option right in the canvas, so to speak.
Yep, exactly. And there's more to come as well. So we will enable you to do things like enable or disable what we call barge in, which is, let's say the bot is reading out a long greeting like it was just then. You want to probably by default be able to allow the user to interrupt that, because maybe they've called before, they know they just want to say, I want to make a reservation. But let's say you are reading out terms and conditions and they are incredibly important and everybody must listen to them. Well, you can enable or disable barge in at the individual message level to make sure that you can control that. And we'll add things like silence detection as well, so that if you ask the user a question and they don't respond, then we can send an event to your bot and your bot can then respond in the appropriate manner, you know, however you deem fit.
With the angry voice, obviously.
I think so, yes. Why aren't you saying anything?
This is so cool. Well, Gary, where can people go to find out more, my friend?
Yeah, so as I said earlier, at Build, we've announced a technology preview. So this is available to try now. You can sign up for that technology preview by checking it out at this link below. This takes you to our blog with all of our Build announcements and all of the details about how you can get started to sign up. And we are so excited to get people's feedback. The initial feedback we've had from folks, even just in the last few days, has been amazing.
Well, I'll give you my feedback. This is delightful. I feel like I need to add some of this stuff to my website, maybe even have a call this number if you want to ask me something and I can respond with, you know, Seth angry or Jenny angry or whatever. Don't ask me questions.
Exactly.
Send me a text message. This is so cool. Gary, thank you so much for being with us, my friend.
Thanks so much.
All right. Thank you so much for being with us. You as well. We've been learning all about the evolution of Power Virtual Agents here on the AI Show. Thank you so much for watching, and hopefully we'll see you next time. Take care.